upon a time, there was a happy couple who never argued about money. If the people next door bought a big new car, but she had to go on the subway, she never complained. If on her birthday, he just gave her a kiss instead of an expensive present, it was all right with her. If he wanted to go to the neighborhood movie instead of an expensive Broadway show, she never objected. Then they were married. And we've been arguing about money ever since.
Dear, in all the years we've been married, I never did know exactly how much money you make.
Let's keep it that way, shall we?
No, we won't. Because I can't get along on the money you give me, and I don't know how much more to ask for.
Well, what is it that you haven't got, that you need?
Oh, they're too humorous to mention. I don't mean to say that we're living in squander.
Squander? Yes.
But it's just the little things that come up around the house, and I just can't make both ends meet. You know what I think we're trying to do, dear?
What?
We're trying to live within our income.
Shame on us.
Exactly. Now tell me, dear, how much money do you make?
I have a drawing account of $5,200 a year.
$5,200 a year? Is that all?
Do you know many people who make $5,000 a year?
Oh, $5,200. Why didn't you say so?
Trying to hold out on you.
Now, let me see. $5,200 a year, 52 weeks a year. That's $10 a week. No.
No.
I forgot to carry the cider.
And that is what makes it hard. But then, of course, I get a Christmas bonus.
When do you get that?
Decorations Day.
Wait a minute. Christmas. That gives me an idea. What do you think if I made some extra money selling Christmas cards?
In May, Jane?
What of it? May, Jane, July, August, summer's over, Labor Day, October, my birthday, November, Thanksgiving, and boom, it's Christmas.
I think I'll go down and shake up the furnace.
All I have to do is get the cards and some paint, take the orders and make money. There must be big profit in Christmas cards. Doesn't it to you, dear?
I don't know what the profit is, but you're not going.
Oh, sure, you know what profit is. Profit and loss.
Yes, I know.
Profit is the money you make, and loss is the money you don't.
Loss is the money you...
But why think about loss? What have I got to lose? Just two things. The cards, the cost of the paint, and my time.
Just those two?
Yes, sir. That is it. I can get rich. The only way to get rich is to make money.
Find a way to get rich selling Christmas greetings.
I can't miss. It's in the cards.
Beautiful song, isn't it? Especially in the summertime. It's around the middle of December that it gets a little monotonous. I mean, when your radio bangs it out at you all day, or bings it out at you all day. Well, let me see. It was the next day around noon, when I had gone out to lunch, that Jane came down to my office in the advertising firm of Dutton, Sutton, Mutton, and Norris, and took my secretary, Miss Anderson, into the Christmas card business as a partner. You couldn't have made a wiser choice. Miss Anderson is as sharp as a marble. Witness this business conference.
And I thought we could use your desk as an office, Sally, and sell the cards right from here. Do you want to be a partner?
Christmas cards in May, Jane.
Oh, what of it? May, Jane, July, August, the summer's over, Labor Day, October, my birthday, November, Thanksgiving, and boom, it's Christmas.
Well, when you put it that way, Jane, but I don't know much about business. I have my hands full taking dictation here, and...
All we have to do is get some cards, raw cards, and we take orders from people and paint on the cards whatever they want.
But can you paint Christmas cards, Jane? I don't think I can.
Well, what's hard about that? Sure you can, a little snow, a little mistletoe, and Merry Christmas.
Yeah, but how about church windows? People like church windows on Christmas cards. I do. They're hard to paint.
Not if you leave them open. But stop being so practical. All we have to do is buy some raw cards and some paint and start some advertising.
But Jane, that's gotta take money. I haven't got any money.
Who's got money? If I had money, do you think I'd be going into business?
Well, how do you get the cards and the paint and the advertising? That takes money.
We charge it.
Charge it to who?
Well, we charge it to... Oh, Sally. I think that should be charged to whom? To Mr. Proposition or something, and you have to say whom. No offense, of course.
Oh, no, that's all right, Jane.
You're welcome. Now, what was the question again?
Charge it to whom? You've got to pay for the cards and all that stuff.
Oh, no, you've got the cards before the course. First we sell them, and the money we have left over is the profit.
But suppose we don't have any money left over.
Well, that's the money they call a loss.
What do we do with that?
There isn't much you can do with it. Pay our bills and things like that. For the cards and the paint and the advertising. And that's where you come in, Sally. They use a lot of cards and paint around this office here. Where do you order it from?
All our stationery comes from the Zenith Printing Company, and our paint from the Royal Paint Company.
Well, okay, partner. Let's get busy. Call them up. Let's order the stuff. Get them on the phone. You've got to do something if you're going to make all this money. What do you think it is, Christmas?
And this is how I was taken for a sleigh ride in a one-horse open business. First, they call the printer.
Hello, Mr. O'Brien. This is Miss Anderson. This is Mr. Ace's secretary.
Yes, Miss Anderson. And how's Mr. Ace?
He's okay if you like, Mr. Ace. But Mrs. Ace wants to speak to you, Mr. O'Brien.
Give me Sally.
Mrs. Ace? Well, I've never met the lady.
Hello, Mr. O'Brien. This is Mrs. Ace. I want to order some raw cards to make some Christmas cards.
Christmas cards in May?
Another one. What of it? May, June, July, August. Oh, I'm not going through that again. Do you have the cards, Mr. O'Brien?
Sure. How many do you want? A gross?
A gross? How many is that?
A dozen. Is that too many?
No, a dozen seem like too many, does it, Sally?
No, a dozen seem too many.
Okay, Mr. Bryan, a gross.
Okay. And charge it to Dutton, Sutton, London, and Norris, I suppose.
Well...
Thank you, Mrs. Ace. Goodbye.
Then they called the paint company.
I'd like to order some paint, mostly red and green. It's for painting some Christmas cards.
Christmas cards in May?
What of it? Why does everybody say in May? This is getting jerksome. Is this a democracy or isn't it?
After charging the paint supplies to me, they called the little radio station to buy some advertising time.
And so I want to advertise some Christmas cards for sale. Well, what of it?
I didn't say anything.
Oh, I thought you were going to say, in May? Well, do you think you could find a nice place on your radio station for our little advertisement?
I may.
There's that May again. What of it? May, June, July?
So the two card sharps charged everything to me, and I didn't know a thing about it. The radio station sent them a complicated contract. There was a 13-week clause, a non-cancelable clause, a clause charging everything to me, the Santa clause. Now we fade. It's a week later. After dinner at home, I'm sitting there reading baseball scores while Jane and Miss Anderson are getting out Christmas cards. There's a parlay for you. Over the corner of my newspaper, I overhear this choice bit of dialogue.
Me too. Doesn't it get hot painting all this snow?
I'm surprised it stays on in this weather.
That's pretty good. Surprised it stays on. Dear, did you hear? I was reading the paper.
Jane, I'm getting kind of worried. We haven't had one order for cards.
Well, my goodness, Sally. We've only advertised 1 week. Home wasn't built in a day. But when they start to call, we'll be ready for them. We got 40 cards painted. We're making very good headway.
Maybe we started this business a little too early. It's 7 months till Christmas. Could it be we're a little premature?
please, Abby, not in front of him.
No, I mean, we should have taken a holiday a little closer. Maybe Thanksgiving. We could change the cards, you know.
Yeah, these reindeer do look a little like turkeys. But, Sally, we can't change horses in mid-spring.
I guess sure, Jane. You advertise the right phone number?
Sure, I'm sure. I gave both telephone numbers, the house and the office. Don't worry so much, Sally. It's a little slow now, but business will pick up by creeps and bounds. We'll be selling Christmas cards like a horse on fire before you even... Dear, what are you doing?
What? I'm just calling up to the drugstore to get some cigars.
Put that phone down. That's a business phone.
Business phone? I need some cigars.
Somebody might be trying to call to put an order in, and all that business goes up in smoke. If you want cigars, why don't you walk up to the corner store and get them?
Isn't that awful? All right, I'll go up to the corner.
Thanks, dear. All right, Sally, let's get back to work. Now be careful, not too much snow. We've got snow all over these things, and I... Dear, haven't you gone yet? What are you looking for?
My earbuds and galoshes.
The beautiful sight, I'm happy at night, walking in a winter wonderland.
I rushed out of our apartment down the corridor. I suddenly got a brilliant idea. I stopped short. Whoa, Prince the Prancer. Whoa, Dancer. Whoa, Martha Graham. I pulled the sled up in front of the 1.5-room igloo of our next door neighbor, Ken Roberts. He's the radio announcer.
Well, come on in, Mr. East. Where's Jane?
Jane is busy getting out Christmas cards.
Christmas cards in May?
What of it? May, June, July, Saratoga, September, Bowie, November, Santa Anita, and boom, it's Christmas. May I use your phone, Ken?
Sure. What's the matter? Your phone out of order?
No, it's a business phone. Jane and her cousin, Miss Anderson, have gotten into the Christmas card business, and they haven't had any orders yet. So I thought I'd help them out.
Oh, I get it. Go ahead and use the phone.
I'd hate to bother you.
Oh, it's quite all right. Anytime, make your call.
Thank you.
Do you think she'll recognize your voice?
I don't think so, Papa.
That's pretty good. Ever thought of going on the radio, Mr. Ace?
Where I hail from, we call that rodeo, son.
Hello?
Hello there.
Yes, who are you calling, please?
I understand you're selling Christmas cards, ma'am.
Christmas cards? Yes, sir. Just a minute. Pencil, Sally. Yes, sir. What can I do for you, sir?
Well, sir, how much are they, ma'am?
Well, we have different prices. Depends on how many you want to buy. The more you buy, the cheaper it is. Like, we charge $5 for one dozen. But if you want to buy 2 dozen, we charge $7.50. The more you buy, the less they are. How many did you want, sir?
One.
One.
One, ma'am.
One dozen, you mean.
No, ma'am. Just one card.
Just one card. One. The first number in the alphabet.
Yes, that's right, ma'am.
Well, how about all your friends?
I don't have any friends, ma'am. It's just my horse on the lone prairie. How much would one card be, ma'am?
Well, I don't exactly know.
What kind of business are you running that you don't know the prices?
Oh, I know the prices for a dozen, or for 2 dozen, and so-so, and so-so. But we just haven't figured out how much one would be.
We? Who's we, gal?
My partner and I.
Howdy, partner!
Really? What did you say your name was?
My name is Austin Dallas from Fort Worth, ma'am. My friends call me Cheyenne. Why do I have something special on my Christmas card?
Well, we have some with snow, some with holly, and some with open church windows.
No cactus?
Cactus in the snow? I never heard of that.
I never heard of Christmas cards in May.
Oh, you too.
What's that, gal?
Nothing. Well, if you want cactus, we'll give you cactus. But you'll have to call me back, and I'll let you know how much one costs. Call me back in about half an hour.
Adios, amigo. Buenos Pancho. Rancho Grande.
Ah, yippee!
Oh,
telephone call, I nosed posey on over to my own corral, dusted all the sagebrush off my chest, unblowed my legs, and walked in. And there they were, two empty saddles, messing around with old paint and new Christmas cards.
Dia, you missed it. We just had an order.
Really, Jane?
Some more than one Christmas card.
Sally, I know that's about the least anyone could order, but it's a good start. Now, what we have to do is figure out how much to charge him.
Who is he, Jane?
I don't know. Sounds like a cowboy or something. Talk with the Western drool. And instead of mistletoe, he wants cactuses on his card.
Cacti, Jane.
Beg pardon?
The plural of cactus is cacti.
Oh, I didn't know that. Thanks, dear.
You're welcome, Jane. Glad to be of service. Call me anytime. I'll admit above.
Well, so much for grammar. How about arithmetic? Jane, how much are we going to charge him?
Well, that's the fly in the oatmeal. Now, let's figure it out. The more you buy, the less it is. Is that right?
That's right, Jane.
The less you buy, the more it is. Did I say that right?
I think so.
Wait, I'll say it over again. Now, listen carefully.
I'm listening.
Not you, dear. Stop that.
What did I do?
I don't like the tone in your eye. We're talking business. We gotta figure this out before he calls back. Please stay out of this.
Well, I can see I'm not wanted around here. I think I'll go over and visit with Ken Roberts for a while.
Yes, you do that, dear. Wait a minute. You're not going visiting looking like that, are you? Button up your shirt and collar and put on your necktie.
Necktie?
Cactus cacti, nectus necktie.
Ken, do you remember the name I used before?
Somewhere in Texas, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Dallas.
Hello?
Hello there, ma'am!
Hello there!
Have you figured out how much that Christmas card is gonna cost me?
My partner and I are just figuring it out.
Howdy, partner!
Howdy! Well, here's the way we figure it. The more you buy, the less you pay. So the less you pay, the more you buy. Did I say that right?
No, ma'am. I don't think so, ma'am.
No, I wasn't asking you did I say that right. I was asking my partner did I say that right.
Howdy, partner!
Just a minute. I'll ask her again. Hold your horse.
Whoa there.
What did she say?
She's asking Miss Anderson. They're trying to figure out just how much.
Hello?
Hello there, partner.
Hello there, partner. Well, this is the way we figured it out. You can't break a dozen. So we'll sell you a dozen for $5. But you can use one if you want to, or all of them. That's our black bottom price.
But I can't use a dozen, ma'am. Nobody to send them to.
Well, my advice to you is to be friendlier between now and Christmas.
I'll just stick to my old horse.
Aren't you married?
Gosh, no, ma'am.
Well, would you like to meet a nice young lady who is a very good secretary and owns half interest in a Christmas card business and is willing to travel west?
I'll just stick to my horse. I don't mind paying $5, ma'am, but I want something pretty good for my money. Something new, something novel. Rustle up something for me and I'll call you later, ma'am.
All right, call me back in half an hour.
I'll do that, ma'am.
They still haven't caught on.
No, Ken, but I'm afraid they might. I keep walking out every time the call comes through, so while I'm over there, can you do a Western call?
Sure as shooting, partner. Out of rain, we're gals out here in the West, we're men are men, and women are glad of it, partner.
Okay, Ken, don't ham it up.
Smile when you say that, stranger.
Something different. And I think this is just what. Oh, is that you, dear?
Yes, Jane.
Well, dear, you missed it again. He just called again. Every time you go out, he calls.
Your customer?
Yes, you never hear when he calls.
Strange.
Yes. I'm beginning to think it's very strange.
Yeah, I'm beginning to think it's very strange too, if you know what I mean.
No, I don't know what you mean.
What do you mean, Sally?
Jane, does doesn't it strike you as peculiar that every time that man calls, your husband isn't here?
Sally, I just said that. Please pay attention.
Yes, pay attention.
Dear, do you think this is novel enough? He says he wants something different, so I made this up. Happy Christmas, Merry New Year.
Happy Christmas.
Yeah, instead of vice versa, instead of Merry Christmas, Happy New Year.
Yes, I get it, Jacob. But I don't think that's so novel. Hey, here, I got an idea. Give me that pencil. Now watch this. First you paint Xmas, X-M-A-S, straight up and down. Now, after the M, you put A-R-K-S. Makes it marks. After the S, you write P-O-T, spot. Makes it spot. Now you've got X marks a spot. Under that, you paint where I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Hey, dear, that's pretty good. Look, Sally, did you see that?
I'm still wondering why he's never here when those phone calls come in. Jane, I suspect foul play.
What are you talking about, Sally? You're always trying to complicate things instead of trying to simplicate them.
Well, it just strikes me as peculiar that he's never here when the phone rings.
Miss Anderson, are you implying that I made those phone calls?
You did? How could you make them? Wouldn't I know your voice? Besides, you're married, and where would you get a horse? You put in a call, did you?
Jane. How could you doubt me?
Jane, the phone.
Oh, the phone. Now we'll see what's going on here or not. Hello?
Hello there!
Hold the phone, please. Hello, dear.
Hello, Jane. What's that for?
Sorry I doubted you, dear. Forgive me.
I think it's over, Jane.
That's sweet. Hello there, partner.
Hello there, partner!
Well, we sure got a novel idea. The card is going to say X-M-A-S, only we're going to write in some extra words. So it'll say X marks the spot where I wish you a Merry Christmas, you see?
Sounds great, partner. 5 out of 5. I'll take 1,000 of them.
1,000? You want 1,000 cards now? 1,000?
1,000? What's he doing?
I thought you said you only wanted one card for your horse.
Well, just bought 1,000 head of cattle, man. Don't want no hard feelings between my cattle and my horse.
But you know 1,000 cards will cost a lot of money.
Money? What's money to me?
Just a minute, please. Sally, he wants 1,000 cards. We'll have to buy more cards right away. More paint.
Wait a minute, Jane. Wait, this is getting out of hand. This little project is going to run into money. Now, he doesn't want 1,000 cards.
He did too. Here. You asked him if he didn't.
Okay. Hello?
Hello there, Tenderfoot.
Okay, take it easy. Don't get carried away.
Hold on, stranger. What's your handle?
Enough is enough, if you know what I mean.
Enough. Where I hail from, down in Texas, enough is for poor folks.
Very good. Yes. But you better call, tell these ladies that you really don't want 1,000 cards.
Tia, don't say that.
Partner, when I say 1,000, I mean 1,000.
Yes. Look, there's... You're gonna run a printing mill and paint now. Let's not overdo this thing. I don't want this to cost money.
Dear, give me the phone.
Money? What's money to me, partner?
All right, character actor.
I got oil wells, cotton gins, tobacco plantations, mint juleps, banjo on the knee. The sun shines east, the sun shines west, but what I do with the sun shines.
Look, Jolson, listen, mister, I know you're rolling in money, but don't you think you better tell the ladies you want to see one sample card first?
Okay, partner. I'll take 1,000 sample cards.
One sample card, okay?
Now where I come from, we don't take one or nothing.
Yes, sir. One sample. I'll tell them.
I got oil wells, cotton jeans, tobacco plantations.
Well, there you go. That's what comes of giving an announcer too many lines to read. He nearly cost me a lot of money convince the Christmas card magnates to have only one card made. However, the next morning at the office, there suddenly appeared on my desk some strange bills. I called in Miss Anderson. What are these bills for, Miss Anderson?
Bills?
Yes. Printer, paint company, radio station. You don't mean you and Jane have been charging all this stuff to me?
Well, we're gonna pay it back from the money we made on the 1,000 cards.
Oh, no. $200 worth of bills? I'm gonna be stuck with them.
But you're not gonna be stuck for it. We're gonna pay you back.
Dia, guess what happened?
Hello, Jane.
Sally, the princess just called me.
Just a minute, Jane. You charged this $200 worth of junk to me?
Well, you don't have to worry about it, Dia. You know that sample card I gave to Mr. O'Brien, the princess?
I'm not interested in any
sample. He just called me up. And he says he liked the idea so much he wants to buy it for $500.
I am not interested in $500.
He just called me. Shall I take it?
Shall you take it? You'll take it and pay this $200 bill for the bill.
Jane, we made $300. Clear profit.
You see, Sally, that's the profit I was telling you about. You see, dear, that's using the old chromium, isn't it?
Look, Chromo. You're lucky I didn't get stuck for those bills. And after this, please, don't charge anything to this office.
Hello, folks.
Ken, guess what just happened? I sold the idea for $500.
Yeah? Gee, that's great, Jane.
Oh, but Jane, suppose that man calls for his Christmas card.
Don't worry about that. He won't call. There isn't any customer.
How can you say that, dear?
How can I say that?
Oh, there he is, Sally. You answer it and tell him.
No, Jane. That was I. I was the one that called.
You were here when he called.
Hello there!
Oh, there he is again. I'll answer it this time.
Oh, no, Jane. I did that. I called last night. Pretty good, wasn't it?
That was a good one on you, wasn't it, Jane?
Oh, yes. Well, the laugh's on the other foot now, because I made $300, didn't we, Sally?
And I know just what I'm going to buy with my half, Jane.
Let's go shopping. We'll charge it to you, and we'll pay you when we get the money from the printer.
Okay, go ahead.
I saw that cute dress, Jane.
I've got to get some shoes.
Oh, you got to be first.
All right.
Well, that was a narrow escape. I almost got stuck for $200. If they hadn't sold that thing to the printer,
wait till they find out about that.
What?
Sure. I called up Jane up and I told her I was Mr. O'Brien, the printer, and I asked them if they'd be taking $500 for their cards.
Oh, no.
Son of the old song, like Bellani's legs and waters with the banjo on me.
Isn't that awful?
So, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the end of another broadcast. We hope that you have enjoyed your journey to the not so long ago. We return you now to 2018. We will see you again for our shows on August 29th and December 2nd. So mark your calendars and check the library website. And as always, we thank you for your time. This time, until next time. This is WREP signing off.